thank you, Ray. It's great being back and hosting Saturday Night Live for the second time. I hosted 15 years ago in 1980 and apparently made such an impression on them. They said, boy, we got to have this guy back as soon as possible. It's wonderful coming to New York. I don't get to New York enough, and I love the skyline, especially love the Empire State Building when it's lit up. And it always reminds me of King Kong, because King Kong is my favorite monster movie, if not my favorite movie of all time. Now, I'll get back to that in a minute. I have held a lot of different jobs. In my life, I was an accountant. I once worked for the Illinois State Unemployment Compensation Board, behind the counter, this is true. And at that time, we made $60 a week, and the claimants made $55. This is true. And they only had to come in one day a week. Now, it took me about a week to figure that out. So I arranged to get fired and wound up on the other side of the line and only had to come in one day a week. Now, any job I've ever taken, I always had to go through a one-week orientation program over the problems you could expect to face your first day on the job. Now, invariably, your first day on the job, the problem you faced was entirely different than was ever covered in the orientation program. All right, now to get back to King Kong. I wondered if the night that King Kong climbed the outside of the Empire State Building was also the first night for a new guard. He had gone through a 1 week's orientation program on the problems he might be expected to face his first night on the job. I think his first night would have gone something like this. Mr. Hennessy? Yeah. Yes, sir, I hate to bother you at home like this, but something's come up and it isn't covered in the guard's manual. I looked in the index yesterday. I looked under unauthorized personnel and people without passes and apes and apes toes. There's an ape's toe sticking through the window, sir. Well, see, this isn't your standard ape, sir. He's between 18 and 19 stories high, depending on whether we have a 13th floor or not. Yeah, well, I'm sure there's a rule against apes shaping the building, so I yelled at his feet. I said, shoe ape, and... I'm sorry, but you're going to have to leave. And I know how you like the new men to think on their feet, so I went to the broom closet without signing out a requisition. I will tomorrow, yes, sir. And I started banging him on the toes with it, you know. But see, there are all these planes flying around his head, and they're shooting at him, and he's kind of swatting at them, you know. Did I try hitting him in the face with it? Well, I was going to take the elevator up to his head, sir, but see, my jurisdiction only extends to his navel. You don't care what I do, just get the ape off the building. This could complicate things a little, sir. When he came by here, he was carrying a woman in his hand. Well, she was wearing a kind of negligee, so I doubt if she's one of the cleaning women. Well, I filled out a report on it. Yes, sir. Well, I don't think I can cover it up. No, sir. You know, as I said, the planes are shooting at him, and they're starting to hit him, and, you know, people are going to come to work tomorrow morning, and, you know, they're going to have to walk around the big dead ape in the street and start putting two and two together, you know. You don't care what I do, just get the ape off the building. Well, I had an idea, sir, but, you know, we're not supposed to leave our post. Well, I thought maybe I could smear the Chrysler Building with bananas. Hello? 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 Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. We have a great show for you. Desiree is here, so stick around. We'll be right back.